conditions. In last classes, we have discussed about some important points and activities about the plant tissues. Now, let us discuss another important activity to observe the plant tissues. Yes. What is the aim of this activity? To observe the growing roots. Yes. Here, operators are materials required for this activity. Water, onion, light, microscope, water, etc. These are the important materials required for this activity. Now procedure. Now procedure. Other people. First, you have to take the water like this. Now today like this water then how to fill the water with water. Like this how to pour the water into the bottle. Next, you have to place the onion bulb on the mouth of the bottle. Like this onion bulb on the mouth of the bottle. Onion bulb used in the first activity or previous activity. In previous activity, we cut the tips of the roots to observe the root tips. Okay, to observe the root tips means this is the normal root, this is cut root. This is the normal root, this is normal root, this is cut root. This is cut root. Okay, here another cut root. These are normal roots. These are normal roots. Now,
You have to mark the ending of the cut rope. How to mark the ending of the cut rope?
Like is how to mark by using the color markers. Okay. Next up, now you have to leave for some time, a few days. After 3 days, after 3 to 4 days, or after a week, you have to observe the rooms. Here, you can observe the like this increased roots or grown roots. Observe, if you keep the entire setup for some time, 3 to 4 days or for a week, roots, isn't it clear? Roots which did not cut in previous activity. Okay, which are not cut in the previous activity, they can grow in length. They can grow in length. But roots which were cut in previous activity, they cannot grow. They remain as it is. Their length is the same. Their length is same before activity and after the activity. What is the reason for this? Here reason is actually at the tip of the root, a type of very important specialized tissue is present. A type of specialized tissue is present. That tissue is called actually meristematic tissue. What? Meristematic tissue. Yes, very important. What is meristematic tissue? Here, when we cut the tip of the root, specialized meristematic tissue located at the tip of the root, that is discarded from the root. Then this cut root cannot grow in length because there is no meristematic tissue. Due to the absence of meristematic tissue, this cut root cannot grow in length. Here these cut roots, they do not have the meristematic tissues at their tips because their tips removed from the roots. Okay, when those tips are removed, along with tips, meristematic tissues are also discarded. That is why they cannot grow in length when we keep onion on the water. Here, meristematic tissue is very, very important. It plays an important role in growth. In
understanding. Observe. Next, next, plant tissues are four types. Actually, plant tissues are four types. How many types? Four types. What are they? What are they? First one, meristematic tissue. Meristematic tissue. Second one, dermal tissue. Third one, graft tissue. Fourth one, vascular tissue. Meristematic tissue. Observe carefully. What? Meristematic tissue, dermal tissue, ground tissue, vascular tissue. These are the four important types of the plant tissues. All plant tissues are classified into mainly two types based on their origin. There are two types: simple tissues and complex tissues. What? simple visuals. Next, complex tissues. What are simple tissues? Simple tissues means tissues which are made up of only one type of cells. Tissues which are made up of only one type of cells are called simple tissues. Already I told you tissue. What is tissue? Already I told you tissue means. Tissue means group of cells. Tissue means group of cells. Already I told you group of cells. Simple tissue means tissues which are made up of only one type of cells. Means cells present in simple tissues are similar in structure and origin and they perform a similar function. Simple tissues means all cells present in the tissue are only one type of one type. They belong to only one type. If tissues are made up of only one type of cells, only one type of cells, then it is called simple tissues. Okay. Examples: meristematic tissues, ground tissues. Ground tissues dermal tissue. These are the simple tissues. Next, complex tissues means tissues which are made up of which are made up of more than one type of cells. More than one type of cells. They are called complex tissue. Actually, there are two complex tissues in plant body. There are xylem and phloem. Xylem and phloem. These two are the complex tissues. Simple tissues. Ground tissue, dermal tissue. Okay, other ones. Okay, let us discuss the all the plant tissues one by one. First of all, the meristematic tissues. First of all, the meristematic tissues. Meristematic tissues. They are very important characteristic feature, that is continuous cell division. What? Continuous. What? Continuous cell division. It is very important. They are involved in cell division continuously and they divide continuously forming the new cells. Understanding? Meristematic cells divide continuously. Continuously forming the new cells. Forming the new cells. That is why meristematic cells are or meristematic tissue is responsible for the growth. Responsible for the growth in length and width. Okay, meristematic tissue is made up of meristematic cells. What are the cells? All cells are arranged in compact with without intercellular spaces. Without intercellular spaces, all cells are arranged in compact like this. Also, characteristic features of the meristematic cells. Cells are arranged compactly. Without any intercellular spaces.
What? Without intercellular presence.
What are intercellular spaces?
This is a cell, this is another cell, this is another one. Therefore, between these three cells, there is small gap is present. It is filled with air. A small gap is present. It is called. It is called here. Intercellular space. Intercellular space.
But in meristematic tissue, there are no intercellular spaces between the meristematic cells.
Next, the meristematic cells are very small in size.
Meristematic cells are very small in size. Okay, observe it. That is what you know. Next,
they have very thin. They have very thin cell wall. They have thin cell wall and prominent nucleus. Prominent nucleus. Observe, these are important characteristic features of the meristematic tissue. Meristematic tissue cells. Okay, observe one sound.
Next,
the world,
based on the location. Meristematic tissues are three types. Based on the location, meristematic tissues are three types. First type, apical meristematic tissue or apical meristem. Next, lateral meristematic tissue or meristem. Next one, intercalary meristem. These are three types. First one, apical meristem, lateral meristem, intercalary meristem. Now let's discuss about the apical meristematic tissue. Okay, apical meristematic tissue, where is it located actually? Actually, it is located at apical regions of the stem. Apical region of the all balls of entire plant. Apical regions of the plant means apical region of stem, apical region of roots, apical region of leaf. Like this, at apical growing regions, apical meristematic tissue is located. For example, this is a imagine is a root and apical region of the root. We can observe this. Meristem, apical meristematic tissue. Next, at the tip of the stem, at the tip of the stem, at the tip of the stem, there also apical meristem is present. Next, at margins and at apex of the leaf, at apex of the leaf, here also apical meristem is present. What is the function of the apical meristematic tissue? What is the main function? Growth and length. Now where will the growth in length, growth in length. This is the main function of the apical meristematic tissue. Here it is responsible for the growth of the stem. Here it is responsible for the growth of the roots. Here it is responsible for the growth of the leaf. Growth of the leaf. Like this, growth in length. This is the main function of the meristematic. Which meristematic tissue? Apical meristematic tissue. Understanding. Observably, all important points about the apical meristem. What? Apical meristem. Next, lateral meristem, it is located at the lateral regions of the stem, it is also called as lateral meristem circumflex, carpocambium. Carpocambium vascular cambium. These two are very important during the secondary growth of the stem. It is responsible for the formation of the bark. Next, it is responsible for the growth of the roots. Vascular cambium. It is responsible for the increase of secondary phloem, secondary phloem, vascular cambium helps here. Observe carefully. Means two are responsible for growth in. Two are responsible for the growth in width. Growth in the diameter. These two are responsible for the growth in width. Or growth in diameter. Lateral meristem. Actually, in sugarcane-like plants. In sugarcane like plants, they are responsible for the increase in length or increase of the increase in length of the internodes. Increase
The responsible increase the length of the internal.
This is also an important function of the lateral meristematic meristem.
Now, intercalary meristem. Lateral meristem of, for example, vascular cambium is present. Vascular cambium is present. In between these two, jilum and phloem. Okay, like this, jilum, between the jilum and phloem, meristem, vascular meristem is present. Vascular meristem is present here. Are you understanding? But the intercalary meristematic tissue is present are the branches or are the sides of the branches are the sides. Intercalary meristematic tissue, these are presented, this is present in between the different types of tissues. For example, dermal tissue is present here. This is the dermal tissue, imagine. Next here, brown tissue is also present. In between the, all these tissues, meristematic tissue is present. It is called intercalary meristematic tissue. What is the function of the intercalary meristematic tissue? Here, from the intercalary meristematic tissue, branches, flowers, leaves, these type of plant pods are originated. Okay. For example, this is node region of the stem. Imagine. This is a node region of the stem. Here, intercalary meristematic tissue is located regions of the stem from where leaves, branches, flowers are developed. From those regions, isn't it clear? Are those regions intercalary meristematic tissue is present. What is the location of the apical meristem? It is located at apical regions of the stem, roots, leaves. Next to lateral meristem. Lateral meristematic tissues are located at lateral sides of the at lateral regions of the stem. Next to intercalary meristematic tissues. They are presented at the regions of the stem from where branches, flowers, leaves are developed. These are the three important types of meristematic tissues. Okay. Let's discuss once again after apical meristematic tissue. Or apical region. Imagine it is a root system. This is the tip of the roots. Now here this is root cap. Here are the tip of the roots. What type of meristematic tissue is present? It is the apical meristematic tissue. Apical meristem. This is also called as
root apical meristem,
root apical meristem,
ram. Okay, next the same way are the tips of the shoots, are the tips of the stem. They also back of meristematic tissue is present. It is called apical meristematic tissue. It is also called as shoot apical meristem. Shoot apical meristem. Next up are the apex of the leaf. Here also a type of meristematic tissue is present. Type of meristematic tissue, it is also called as apical meristematic tissue. Apical meristem. Yes.
What is the function of the apical meristem? Main function is growth in length. Growth in length. It is the main function of the apical meristem. Now let's discuss about the lateral meristem. Lateral meristem. This is again two types, corpocambium, vascular cambium. Corpocambium, during the secondary growth, corpocambium forms bark cork. Now very well that here, corpocambium forms the different types of tissues. Secondary phloem, cork. Secondary phloem, secondary cortex. Is it given here? Secondary cortex. Like this. Next to vascular cambium, it is responsible for the development of the secondary jhilum, secondary phloem. Okay, means these two are responsible for the growth in width or diameter. Yes, this is the main function of the lateral meristem. Growth in width, this is the main function of the lateral meristem. Growth in length, this is the function of the apical meristem. Now intracalary meristem, it is responsible for the production of the leaves, branches, flowers. What is the location of the intracalary meristematic tissue? Listen carefully here. Regions of the stem from where leaves, branches, flowers are developed. And those regions intracalary meristematic tissues are present.